Hey, it's Anastasia from Kick Consulting, and I want to show you just quickly how monday.com can work for mortgage brokers. Now, I'm an ex-mortgage broker, and since I started with Kick and working with Monday, I've put a lot of thought into how this could work for mortgage brokers because I can see how it could save brokers, especially those that are looking to scale and grow, a lot of time and effort and mucking around with lots of different softwares. So let's show you how. So, aggregator software, as we all know, we have to use for compliance reasons. We have to submit through there, we have to work through AOL, and that often means that everything else is in spreadsheets or folders, sticky notes, or whiteboards because things just don't tend to work together. Aggregator software generally sucks. It's not something that does everything, it only does a couple of things well, and sometimes not even that well. So, what can Monday do for you? It can improve communication between your teams, referral partners, and clients, increase efficiency, and I'll show you how. It can bridge the gaps between the different softwares that you have to use in your day-to-day. It can give you better tracking and reporting so that you know where your business has been and where it's going, and better customer service for those all-important repeat and referral clients. How? Now, how I see it is Monday acts as your central hub between your aggregator software, such as My CRM or Mercury, File Invite or other document softwares, DocuSign for your signatures, Gmail or Outlook integrates really nicely, and you can integrate with something like Calendly for your calendar and appointment bookings. What can it do? I won't run through all of these, but to give you an idea, initially this was designed as a project and workflow management software. Now, I see each deal as a mini project. There are a set number of tasks that need to be done by different team members at each stage. Some of that will depend on the type of deal, whether it's a refi, whether it's a purchase, SMSF, if anybody out there is still doing many of those, all have different sets of tasks. Now, depending on what you choose when the data is put into the system, you can have the tasks that are required at each stage automatically assigned to people within your teams. You can have due date tracking. You've got built-in messaging, which is attached to each deal so that everything is transparent between your teams and between your team members. You can have document collaboration, so your docs can be saved and you can add your notes against documents. You've got integrations, as I mentioned before, with most aggregator softwares, things like File Invite, Outlook, or Gmail. We are looking into Quickly as well. We're talking with them at the moment as far as integrations are concerned. Outlook and Gmail just are a given. Calendly for your calendar bookings and management. Now, monday.com has the enterprise level of monday.com has brilliant data security. Now, that's something that I know a lot of brokers are concerned about when it comes to compliance. Now, the level of data security that the enterprise level of monday.com has is basically your government or bank level style security. You've got, as we say there, your single sign-on, which is really handy for your teams as well. And then a bunch of different certifications around security that I don't know the ins and outs of, but I know that it means that you can trust that the data that you put into the system is secure. Reporting, you can have whatever data you like. Anything that's in Monday can be reported on, and you can see it visually in the way that you like to see it. So, if you're a graphs person, that's great. If you're a table person, Kanban, any of those views that you like to work in or how you like to see your data, it's very, very customizable. What I see it though is as a holistic hub. So one thing that it does really well that you won't find a lot of your aggregator softwares and things like that do are it connects your teams together. So your sales team, your admin team, HR, marketing, everybody has transparency and can communicate in one central place. So you're not emailing documents back and forth between teams. Anybody in your teams can log in and see the information that they need to see. Let's visualize it. Now, we start with obviously marketing and sales. So you've got your campaigns or lead sources coming in. Now, monday.com forms, if you've used something like Typeform or Google Forms in the past, monday.com forms is fairly similar to that, but it's brilliant in that it's directly linked to your boards. So any information that comes in through a monday.com form just comes straight into your incoming leads board. Your monday.com forms can be embedded in your website as well. So they can be made to look pretty in your brand colors and be added to your websites. They can be added to emails. You've also got the external integrations that I spoke about before, whether it's your aggregator software or somewhere else that you've got leads coming in. Anything, if you have a look, anything that connects to Zapier or Make can connect through to Monday. And then you've got manual entry as well. So you or your teams can manually enter customer data straight into the board. Nice and easily there. So your boards can take you through the process of incoming leads, different set of tasks that need to happen there, whether you reach out to them by email or by phone, you assign them to different people along the way, qualification after you've had a qualification chat, or whether you get them to fill out a mini fact find at that point. And then it can be turned into an opportunity. And then when closed, it can turn into a deal, which is where you start doing your proper fact find and docs, where we can link into something like your aggregator software again or file invite. Or you could use those monday.com forms again for clients to upload information and documents directly into Monday. So that might be something worth looking at as well, and it could save you having another file invite subscription, if you're happy with how that works. Now, it'll run you through things like your lodgements, deal milestones, post-approval and up to settlement. Now, as your milestones are tracked in your linked aggregator software, such as Mercury or MyCRM, chances are you can push that data backwards into Monday, and then that can create a next set of templated tasks for your team. So if a file is pre-approved with outstandings from the lender, and that goes through your aggregator software, from AOL, then it can come into Monday and automatically give a set of tasks either to the broker that's assigned or the admin person that's assigned to the deal to follow up the customer for those outstanding items. Once the deal has settled, your admin team can use it for your commission tracking and then staff payments to make sure that the commission comes in from the lender in a decent time frame, and then also automatically see who that belongs to and who it needs to be paid to nice and easily. You can also link into things like Xero, so you can have it coming straight through. The data can come straight back into Xero to help with those staff payments and commission tracking there. All right, a couple of standalone boards that could be linked in but aren't necessarily part of the workflow stuff, workload management. So from a management perspective or a HR perspective, keeping an eye on how much any staff member has on their plate. You can see how many deals they've got attached to them, how many tasks they've got attached to them, so that you can make sure that nobody is either completely overwhelmed and on the road to burnout, or on the other side, somebody is sitting there twiddling their thumbs a little bit, not too sure what to do next because they don't have anything set against them. You can use it as a central document storage hub, so you can have your current documents or your versioned documents all sitting in Monday so that you've got one place to look. So you're not going looking in a bunch of different folders or different areas for current documents. Same with links. If you've got a global links library, you can make sure that everybody in the team is using the same links to things such as servicing calculators or bank logins. For your HR staff management, it is really nice for setting up onboarding processes and offboarding processes there as well. Also keeping an eye on the nice warm and fuzzy things such as birthdays and anniversaries, things like that. One thing I really love that it can do is how it can handle your referral partners. Now, referral partners, as we know, are crucial to a mortgage broking business. And it's where we should be getting a lot of the business that comes in. So what if your referral partners could use their own link to jump in and see where each of their shared clients' deals are up to? See if they're pre-approved, waiting on documents from clients, whether they are formally approved and just now waiting on settlement. If they could see that information rather than having to give you a call, chase you down, send you SMSs and emails asking, where's this up to, where's this up to, where's this up to? And with enterprise level security and permissions, you can set exactly how those referral partners log in and exactly what they can see and what they can't see. So you're not giving them free for all access over your client file, because as we know, that breaks a bunch of compliance and privacy laws. But what it can do is give them a very, very brief snapshot of where the file is up to at the moment, just to give them that peace of mind that everything is moving as it should without having to chase you down. So if any of that sounds good, let's have a chat. You can use the QR code there to book in a time to have a chat with us. My email address is there and our website. I'd love to talk and I'd love some feedback.